We're going to talk a little bit more about streaming, and in particular, specific applications and how they work. We'll talk about a streaming video application, YouTube, and a voiceover IP or streaming audio application, Skype. With YouTube, all uploaded videos are converted to Flash or HTML5, and nearly every browser has a Flash plugin. Thus, every browser can essentially play these videos. HTTP and TCP are implemented in every browser, and the streams easily get through most firewalls. So in this case, even though we've talked about why TCP is suboptimal for streaming, the designers of YouTube decided to keep things simple, potentially at the expense of video quality. When a client makes an HTTP request to YouTube.com, it is redirected to a content distribution network server located in a content distribution network such as Limelight or perhaps even YouTube's own content distribution network. We will talk about content distribution networks later on in this course. When the client sends an HTTP GET message to this CDN server, the server responds with a video stream. Similarly, with Skype or voice over IP, your analog signal is digitized through an A to D conversion, and then this resulting digitized bit stream is sent over the internet. In the case of Skype, this A to D conversion happens by way of the application, and in the case of voice over IP, this conversion might be performed with some kind of phone adapter that you actually plug your phone into. An example of that might be Vonage. In VoIP with an analog phone, the adapter converts between the analog and digital signal. It sends and receives data packets and then communicates with the phone in a standard way. Skype, on the other hand, is based on what's known as peer-to-peer technology, where individual users using Skype actually route voice traffic through one another. We will talk more about peer-to-peer content distribution later in this course.